Now, it's been more than 30 years since I sat right where you all sit today. I was so happy to say goodbye to sleepless nights in the computer lab. I was happy to say goodbye to days of solving quadratic equations and pondering when I would ever possibly need a class like matrices again. And yet, I was filled with both excitement and a healthy bit of uncertainty about what may lie ahead. Today, each of you will officially become an engineer. Now, with the exception of those of you continuing on to grad school, most of you may be thinking, and possibly with a little bit of relief, that your classroom days are far behind you. But don't get too excited about that. Rest assured, as you begin your postgraduate lives, you still have many lessons to learn. The pace of change today requires that your generation become lifelong learners. And as you enter the classroom of the real world, I hope you take these words from author, activist, and Professor Bell Hooks to heart. In her book, Teaching to Transgress, she writes, "I entered the classroom with the conviction that it was crucial for me and every other student to be an active participant, not a passive consumer. Education is the practice of freedom. Education connects the will to know with the will to become." I hope you heed the words of Dr. Hooks. I hope that you minimize the time you, our future technology and engineering leaders, spend as passive consumers of information and technology, and that you maximize your potential as creators of a better, brighter, and more equitable future for us all. And remember that every lesson, even the painful ones, can lead to an ever greater freedom, both for you and for those you serve with the knowledge and skills you've acquired here at UConn. The knowledge and tools that each of you leave this campus with today set you apart from many members in our society. And that gives you a certain unique agency, the ability to understand and dissect complex systems gives you both power and responsibility. Now, what do I mean by agency? Sociologists use the word agency to describe the individual's capacity to make independent decisions and take action. But for me, agency means a little bit more. For me, agency entails making conscious decisions to act from the deepest place within us that knows what is right, even if, and especially if, we're told to do otherwise. Now, it doesn't take much agency to follow the status quo. And the hive mind complex is certainly deeply embedded in our social media saturated world. Now, we have many examples of the use of agency without any responsibility in social media, from the latest Kanye-isms to a barrage, yeah, I thought you guys would get that one, to a barrage of self-serving tweets emanating from even the highest offices of our government. Agency is about much more than this brash individualism or this dragon energy, whatever that is. But my challenge to you is to move beyond the surface display of free will and to claim your personal sense of agency, rooted in a deeply moral sense of freedom, justice, equity. May you embrace the will to not only disagree with the status quo or whatever popular authority figure reigns at the time, but may you embed your use of agency with a consciousness and a will to create change for the betterment of our society. Now, let me tell you what personal agency has meant for me. To do that, I have to talk to you a little bit about my daughter, Kai. As I pause here for a minute, I just want to tell you that driving on the campus yesterday was an especially poignant moment for me. See, my daughter, Kai, recently finalized her college decision and will be entering a computer science, bachelor's degree, She'll be entering a computer science bachelor's degree program in the fall. Now, parents, and for all the parents and guardians here, you'll surely understand how overwhelming this can be. And for the students, not for you as our babies, but for us as parents. I think that your day-to-day is a preview of my daughter's own graduation just 4 years down the road. And today, your parents are probably thinking about how fast this all went by and how much each of you has changed. But they're also thinking about how much you've changed them. I understand this so deeply as a parent and educator. Just 7 years ago, I was just what I call a nerdy mom. I mean, you saw me walk in, I dropped something. I'm a nerd, what can I say? And I was raising a geeky daughter. She was 12 at the time and just really interested in computer gaming. That's literally all she wanted to do then and sometimes now. I never expected my daughter Kai, once a future veterinarian, then a future bassist, next a future artist, to follow in my footsteps and become a computer scientist and engineer. But she did. When the seed for the idea of my organization, Black Girls Code, was planted, it was because I recognized that although my daughter Kai had unparalleled access to technology, she was still very much a consumer of it and not a creator. When I looked beyond Kai, I learned that the number of women and girls receiving degrees in computer engineering had plummeted from a high of about 30% 30 years ago when I graduated from college, to a low of 12% today for women overall. And for women of color, it's less than 3%. But not here. I knew I had to do something about that. As a woman of color in engineering, I was determined to create a better, a more ideal, and perhaps an easier pathway for my daughter and for girls like her. I had to use my agency first in order to free my daughter and her peers to use their agency in the growing technology sector that has systemically shut them out. Since BGC began our journey 7 years ago as a small grassroots organization in a tiny basement in San Francisco with just 8 girls sharing 6 computers, we've seen our organization grow into a movement. We've reached almost 10,000 students to date and have chapters all across the U.S. Our large, hairy, audacious goal is to teach 1 million girls to code by the year 2040 and become the Girl Scouts of technology. Thank you. But enough about BGC. Let's talk about you. This commencement season, many graduating students are going to hear a lot about the challenges you will face in the world. I'm betting I don't have to tell you all that. You know better than us elders what's out there and the difficulties we're facing. Instead, I wanted to suggest that while the challenges are daunting, your generation already has everything you need to lead the way. The world is filled with digital network technologies that have made the world smaller and lowered boundaries. An idea that you develop here as a student at UConn could change the life of someone on the other side of the world with the launch of a single line of computer code. That kind of reach and influence was unimaginable for me and my peers. I'm also so astounded by your generation's openness and willingness to reach across differences to effect change. I pray that you continue to use your reach and influence to push through discrimination and societal barriers to equity and inclusion. As you get involved in the world, and especially as you take on leadership roles, you truly could become the generation that faces and finally resolves centuries of systemic inequality. Involve everyone, regardless of background, in the design process you lead, and leverage the power of diversity of your peers to envision and build the solutions you need to our most intimidating problems. I hope you are as excited about this process as I am excited for you. So to you, newly minted engineers, to you, architects of the future, I ask, how will you use this next level of agency? When you're building new systems, will you ask those systems be accessible and useful to disenfranchised communities? Will you use your skills and your agency to build things that empower others to own their power and their voice? Will you use your ongoing education to contribute to the practice of freedom, as bell hooks wrote? As an engineer, how will you do what is right when the pressure is on to follow the herd or obey an authority figure who's gone off course? I know you'll find a way. I have no doubt about it. Rebels and leaders always find a way. But also understand that agency comes with some risk, and being a change agent will put you in some uncomfortable situations. Brian Stevenson, the executive director of the Equal Justice Initiative and founder of the Anti-Lynching Memorial in Montgomery, Alabama, says that we must be deliberate in our willingness to stand in uncomfortable situations. We must be deliberate in our willingness to stand in uncomfortable spaces. So standing in your power, your agency as a change agent, it may be uncomfortable. But let me tell you something. That feeling of discomfort, it might at first feel like there's something wrong with you. But guess what? There's not. There is something very right about you if you are sensitive to unjust systems. Let that discomfort be your guide. It will tell you when to act. Just a couple of weeks ago, I was moved to tears as I sat in my living room and watched thousands of students on races, creeds, ethnicities come from all over the world to stand in union and communion with the students from Parkland. Those students who stood up, they took their agency in their hands and they said, never again. I see the same capacity as leaders and change agents in each one of you future graduates here today, every single one of you. You are the ones I love this generation. I really do. You are the ones we've been waiting for. And you have all the skills and potential needed to move this needle, to shift the narrative, to build a future that is more fair, more equitable, and more just for you, your families, and for future generations. So when each of you walk across the dais this morning, and Dean Kazrunian and Dean Berkeley hand you your diploma, when you finally go back and pack up your dorm room and leave these rolling grounds of the University of Connecticut, know that you leave this place as much more than just an engineer. You all leave this place as a most powerful agent of change. And I pray that each of you will move boldly into your agency, that you will own your power, that you will continue to grow as active learners, and that you will stand in moments of discomfort, And yes, push right on through it. And do what each and every one of your professors here today has already taught you to do. Build a better world. Be the change. Welcome to engineering, change agents. I can't wait to see the world you build. Thank you.